This is State Fire Marshal Butch Brown, and I'm here with our Honorable Governor, John Bel Edwards. And Governor, it's really an honor to be with you. We appreciate your service and, following you and your leadership and protecting the people of Louisiana. Certainly that passion funnels down to not only the Fire Marshal's deputies, but every firefighter and first responder in this state. And I know you have a message for our first responders and firefighters.
Well, I do, but first, thank you for everything you do as Fire Marshal, and I appreciate everybody at the Fire Marshal's office. But across the state of Louisiana, we have a combination of professional and volunteer firemen who do a tremendous job day in and day out, keeping people in safe and protecting property and doing it so at great exposure to themselves in terms of risk of harm and so forth. So we appreciate that. But I want to encourage everybody to make sure that they have working fire alarms in their homes and a sufficient number of them. And if they can't afford them, don't know exactly how to install them, they need to contact their fire department or go to your website at the fire marshal's office. Make sure that they do that. And then check on your neighbors. You may have an older neighbor, somebody who just not aware of how important it is to have a working fire alarm, smoke detector in their homes. And so we would encourage people to do that and look out for their neighbors, their family members, especially the elderly.
Yes, sir. And, we're seeing some extreme dry conditions in the state. Already a lot of the northwestern parishes are issuing individual burn bans. As you know, you discussed with me, and we're considering some regional burn bans across the state from the state level. Can you give some advice to people who are thinking about incidental burning and whatnot?
Well, first of all, you got to follow the bans. And you can't say, well, I know there's a ban, but I'm just going to create this small fire here, because the conditions are ripe. Everything is so dry. All it takes is a little bit of wind, and you're going to create a tremendous problem and suffer some liability, both civilly and potentially criminally. So it's just not worth doing. Right now, as we're talking, Greece, there is a wildfire in Greece. There are at least 60 people who've been killed, and this is in a tourist area. We think that things like that can't happen in the United States, but they can, and they can happen right here in Louisiana if we're not careful. So we need to follow all of the burn bans, and people should just wait and find other ways to dispose of things. But people should wait until it's safer and the burn bans are lifted before they engage in any of these activities.
Right. Good. One last question. So, Governor, I've watched you grow up. One of the things I've been impressed with you is you grew up in rural Louisiana. Yeah. You're a son of a sheriff, a grandfather sheriff, your brother's been a sheriff. Truly, your family is public service, your mom being a nurse. What advice would you give a young person who is, finding their way through high school, maybe finding their way through college? What advice would you give a young person to seek out passion and be someone at the end of their life they can be proud of?
Well, find a way to serve. And there are so many ways to serve your fellow man. And it doesn't have to be an elected public service, but there's so many ways to do it. At the end of the day, it is extremely rewarding. But being involved. And as you know, Butch, because I know how much you love your job, if you choose to do something that you love, you never feel like you're going to work.
That's right.
So I encourage people to do that. I'm very fortunate to be the governor of a state that I love. I love the people of this state. We have the best, most generous, decent, hardworking people anywhere in the country. And we are a unique state in terms of our culture, our history, the sportsman's paradise, all of that stuff. So I feel very fortunate. My days can be tough. But I love what I do to the point where I don't really feel like I am working,
Right.
So I would encourage everybody to just find what they love and then get involved in
sure,
that. That's
sure.
what I do.
Well, thank you for your service. And certainly
thank you, Butch.
You don't know the people that follow you every day and do that passion. So thank you, Governor.
Thank you.
Okay.